How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? And welcome to your morning cup. We start off today with an incredible news coming out of the United States. Donald Trump has officially signed the COVID relief bill, the bill that he had opposed to earlier, stating that the relief package was not up to par with what is required to make sure that the people of the United States get the relief that they need. Has now been signed and officially passed. He was facing bipartisan pressure from both sides, and now Donald Trump has officially caved and signed the new COVID relief package. He was in Florida, apparently, golfing, and after his golf tour was over, he decided that, yeah, it was about time to sign the COVID relief package. Israel's government has now collapsed, with the fourth election being triggered in the past 2 years. We don't know what the future of Israeli policy means for this, but we also do understand the fact that the Israeli government is now looking at some serious hurdles that it needs to overcome. This government was put together with a coalition between two different parties, and apparently, once this government collapsed, they started blaming each other, just like with every other political party, and a fallout that we anticipate throughout the globe. We move on to the Queen of England and another promising story that's been out about her. The fact that 2020 was a rather shocker of a year for the royal family, with the latest edition of the royal family officially parting ways with their royal responsibilities, stating that they no longer want to be part of the royal family. To Prince Charles, who caught COVID, and which was rather shocking for the rest of the world, considering that he's one of the highest ranking royals there is. From there to the royal resilience that we saw throughout, where Queen Elizabeth had to go out of her way and address the country in a way that she had never done before, stating video conferences as well as messages to her people, saying that everything would be fine, that the NHS would be in action, that the people of the UK would receive the treatment they needed to overcome all of the difficulties that this pandemic brought forth. A new norm was adopted in her rule after a long time, and now she has officially been the only royal that has seen numerous eras and still is here, ever prevalent as always. People have been putting together monoliths across the globe for numerous reasons, basically art projects and a little essence of what might be the unknown, and how we shouldn't be afraid of the unknown and rather be surprised and rather appeased by it. A new gingerbread monolith was observed in San Francisco on Christmas Day, which brought up the spirits of the local people who were otherwise pretty torn down with the whole effects of the pandemic. San Francisco being one of the densely populated regions of the United States, where the humongous homeless population was facing rather difficult times when it came to the wild spread of the coronavirus. With this new monolith, it seems that it's just a little bit of Christmas cheer, along with the holiday season, to make sure that the people have a little something to smile about. We move on to Russian President Vladimir Putin officially stating that he will be receiving the Sputnik V vaccine. He says that the elderly as well as the first responders, just like everywhere else across the world, will be the first people to receive the vaccine. But President Putin has officially stated that he will be receiving the country's first manufactured vaccine. He said that upon the completion of all the formalities, he would be one of the first people in line to make sure that he gets the vaccine, to send a message to the rest of his people that it is rather safe. It is something that needs to be done. We move on to another shocker of a news. The coronavirus variant that was earlier only found in the United Kingdom, which then made its way to Japan and Canada, as we reported yesterday, has now officially found its ways to South Korea. It is rather disappointing, considering the fact that South Korea has been hit with a new wave of coronavirus patients, and a country like South Korea, which dealt with the pandemic the way it did in its initial onset, is now facing rather difficult adversities. The Nashville bomber has been identified, and we are not going to name the bomber on this channel because we do not want to gratify his means by any speck of the imagination. What we do want to put out there is the fact that he was 63 years old, and the means or the reasons behind why or when this entire plan came to fruition for him is still up for grabs. We will keep you updated as soon as we know more, but until then, this is it for that story. Countries across the globe have now officially put in sanctions on New Year's Eve events across the spectrum. People who were otherwise anticipating that, yeah, the governments might put out a certain amount of leniency pardons for certain clubs, certain events to take place, even though the pandemic is on its all-time stride. Well, it turns out that major countries like Australia, like the United Kingdom, of course, like the United States, a lot of these countries have officially said that there will be no mass gatherings, there will be no mass celebrations, and people should stay home and watch the fireworks that are either put in place. Like the Sydney Opera House usually has a fireworks display. People are insisting that they stay home and they watch the fireworks. It'll be covered across the news spectrum. And the same goes across the board for numerous countries, with people still not understanding that the coronavirus is spreading like wildfire. And even though the vaccines are here, it'll be a while before we can return to our new norm. We move on to the final story of the day, being the coronavirus and its effects on the economy throughout the globe. The coronavirus pandemic has done both good and bad for numerous industries. Industries that were manufacturing PPE, that were manufacturing face coverings, or that were manufacturing any kind of thing that could help people maintain certain amount of distance, as well as maintain their own safety when they came in contact with numerous others, have done quite good this year for themselves. The profit margins have gone through the roof. But then again, on the contrary, there are industries that were highly dependent on people and on the general public coming in and interacting, coming in and purchasing their products or purchasing their services. Turns out that these sectors have faced the biggest brunt of the coronavirus pandemic, and we still don't know if this industry will ever be able to make a complete recovery. From movie theaters to amusement parks to anything that you can imagine that you have to step out for, everything is still under lock and key, and we don't know when we might finally be able to return back to what was once our day-to-day life. Until then, this has been your Morning Cup. See you tomorrow.